So, Ko, you're on the Intergovernmental Panel, the co-chair for the Intergovernmental Panel on Climate Change, which for most people know is the biggest scientific body on climate change. It comes out with the scientific pieces that everybody follows in the scenarios and has identified the 1.5 degree limit of global warming. And I'm wondering how what you're seeing in biodiversity converges with what you're seeing on climate. What is that interrelation between the two?
Yeah, our reports find that biodiversity and climate are deeply intertwined. It will actually not be possible to solve one crisis without addressing the other. You know, climate change accelerates biodiversity loss, while biodiversity offers clear solutions to tackle climate change. So on one hand, climate change is increasingly disturbing freshwater, marine, and terrestrial ecosystems. In fact, one-eighth of the millions of animal and plant species are now threatened with extinction, more than ever before in history. And we found that global wildlife populations have plummeted by as much as 70% since 1970. On the other hand, nature-based solutions such as green roofs to cool buildings, preserving bee populations to improve crop yields, or mangroves to store carbon can help ramp up climate change mitigation and adaptation efforts while protecting biodiversity. Land and oceans, for instance, can absorb more than 50% of all carbon emissions if ecosystems remain balanced and intact. So this shows that biodiversity and climate change should be tackled simultaneously. Failing to do so risks leading to unintended and negative consequences for one or the other. And that's why 196 nations are currently gathered in Montreal for the UN Biodiversity Summit. They're trying to secure an agreement to halt and reverse biodiversity loss by 2030 and fully restore it by 2050.